When we're on our way up here, I usually have a lot on my mind. We're planning all the sites and running through your head. You're thinking which sites are going to have water, which are going to be dry, what species are we going to get at which sites? Is that site that had, you know, barking marsh frog last season going to have them again this season? Yeah, I look forward to it every time I come up. So we're here in Millewa Forest, and this is one of our long-term monitoring sites for frog population condition monitoring.
Another parent's tree frog.
And it's one of our sites because it's one of the ones that potentially receives environmental water each year with the flows that they release down the Murray. So we come out here each year and sample the tadpoles with dip netting, pike netting and seine netting, and we're trying to get an understanding of species richness at each site and across the whole forest.
This tatty's very big.
Well, it's the largest river red gum forest in the world. It's a huge floodplain ecosystem, it's really complex. There's a large system of wetland complexes, billabongs, anabranches, floodplain areas. So the Living Murray program is promising to deliver environmental water long term, and we are up here monitoring all of these sites to determine what benefit that's having for the local population, how much watering is enough to support the health of these populations into the long term.
This is one of our audio recorders here in the Millewa Forest. It records all the frog calls that we hear, and it can be here to up to 3 to 4 months, and it's just sitting there recording until we pick it up, listen to what frogs are out there, and then we can try and work out what we have here.
And what we found is that it appears to be that the sites that are receiving more environmental water each year and where that water ponds for longer, the frogs seem to be doing better. There's more calling activity, there's a greater species richness.
Environmental water is crucial to the health of the ecosystem here, and to see the transformation of that environmental water coming in has been amazing. You've heard the frogs creak, the birds come in, you see the bugs and mosquitoes around as well, which is all indicating that healthy ecosystem. And I think when you talk about a healthy ecosystem, we're also talking about a healthy community as well.
I mean, it's a highly managed environment up here. Because we have so much influence over the flow, I think it's a really high priority for us to support the flora and fauna that exists out here naturally. And by doing this kind of monitoring, we can determine how much benefit we're getting from the environmental watering.